Today's episode is going to be a little bit meta because I'm going to be talking about science communication, aka SciComm. This is inspired by the fact that I'm hosting the Twitter account I Am SciComm all this week. It is a rotating Twitter account where a different SciCommer hosts every week. I encourage you to come by, follow along, and chat with me. I would love to hear from you. I'm talking about how I make my content, plans, and of course, science communication. My journey in SciComm started in 2011 when I started Brilliant Botany on Tumblr. I really enjoyed posting my own photos, and it was a great way of reinforcing the things I was learning in my undergraduate botany courses. A lot of the local plants I posted were actually ones I needed to memorize for lab. I expanded to YouTube in 2013 because I wanted to cover more complex, interesting topics. And I was already a member of the YouTube community, having watched Vlogbrothers, Wheezy Waiter, The Brain Scoop, and a lot more. So I was familiar with the platform and knew what I could do with it. I've had a lot of fun making videos because it's more dynamic and offers more opportunities for creativity. It also gives me more opportunities to interact with you guys, the reason I do SciComm, talking to people. My work on Brilliant Botany has connected me to a community of people interested in plants. If someone asks me for a plant ID and I don't know what it is, I can just ask the folks over on Twitter for help. If you've ever thought about sending me an email or hesitated to post a comment, please know I would love to hear from you. I also recently got a PO box, so if snail mail is more your style, you can get the address for that in the link in the description. You can also find my content on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram, all under the handle Brilliant Botany. The internet is just such an amazing resource for science communication, and all of it is free and accessible. There is an abundance of resources on YouTube and otherwise. I've linked some of my favorites in the description, and I encourage you to share some of yours in the comments. All of the people I've linked are phenomenal SciCommers, but I'm going to pick out just a couple of my favorites. Alex Danis posts wonderful personal videos about her lab work. I especially recommend her videos for people interested in lab science or who are interested in pursuing an advanced degree. She is witty, engaging, and her camera presence is phenomenal. Science IRL is a growing channel that also talks about botany, but the host Molly covers more lab science than I do. Check out their videos for explanations of lab processes and look out for season 2, which will be up soon. And finally, Field Notes with Jessica offers resources on geology, a topic I'm somewhat ignorant of. She covers everything from the basics like types of rocks to more complicated concepts like earthquakes. I hope that this video inspired you to check out some new SciCommers, and like I said, please share some in the comments. I'm always looking for new stuff to check out. Thank you so much for watching, and a special thank you to my Patreon supporters who are helping Brilliant Botany grow. Don't forget to hit the like and subscribe button for a new video every Wednesday, and I will see you next time. And I've now decided that anytime I wear floral, it is botanist camouflage, because the plants won't ever see me coming.